Hello and welcome to Behind the Lines. I'm Diane Dayton. Today we're going to talk about the Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance and all the good work that they do in our county and in the state too. With us right now we have Angela Little, and you are the president and CEO. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
And also with us is Terry Clark. Now you are the director of York County Children and Youth and Families, and you're also a board member.
Yes.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
What really is the Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance, Angela?
Well, we're a statewide nonprofit that's worked for the past 40 years to protect Pennsylvania children. And we do that by having parent education and support groups statewide. And we have a very large training program for mandated reporters, those folks who work with kids every day and volunteer so that they understand how to recognize and properly report child abuse.
This is no small task.
It's a large task, and yeah. We need lots of people involved in it.
Yeah, and there really are, just like we have with Terry. Mm-hmm. Tell me what your job is in York County.
Well, it's really to run the County Children Youth Agency and to make sure that when reports come in from people in the community for concerns with children, that we respond to those and respond timely and get out and do the assessment or the investigation and take whatever action that we need to take to ensure the safety of those children.
And when we say children, we're talking about under 18, right?
Yes, yes, under 18.
Okay. Now, there are a lot of things that you do and you provide, but there's some unbelievable statistics. Mm-hmm. Could you tell us more?
Yeah, well, in 2015, which is the year we have the most recent statewide data on, there were 4,203 children that were substantiated as being victims of child abuse. Beyond that, and this number has stayed relatively unchanged over the past several decades, 34 children were killed as a result of child abuse. So on average, each year in Pennsylvania, total of 67 counties, the equivalent of an elementary school classroom of children die as a result of abuse and neglect.
Wow. And there are times that sometimes we may think something is not quite right. You help us identify and give us a way to report.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, PFSA has two main training programs. One that is geared towards professionals and volunteers who are considered required under the law to report child abuse. They're mandated reporters. So we have a training program online and face-to-face. There is no cost for our face-to-face training. It is provided under contract with the Department of Human Services. For folks to really understand what child abuse looks like, what are some of the physical and behavioral indicators, and then what are the proper steps for reporting.
Okay, and you are actively involved with that on a daily basis in York County. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, unfortunately, York County is the third highest in the state of Pennsylvania, behind Philadelphia and Allegheny County, for the number of child abuse reports that we receive in general neglect cases. And that is a difficult job to do, I think, for caseworkers because of the number of cases that come in. But they have to look into each one of those reports and again, try and determine what is in the best interest of the child, mm-hmm. and what has to be done to assure that they're going to be okay.
Yeah. So how can we report something?
Well, there are a few different ways that folks can report. One of the ways that most people are the most familiar with is by calling Childline, the state central registry. And that number is 1-800-932-0313.
Okay. And what happens when we call?
Well, when you make a call to Childline, they take down all the information that you may have, and then they work with to get that information to the county in which the abuse is alleged to have occurred. And then the county's actually responsible, as Terry said, for the investigation. What's really important is for people to understand that the Child Protective Service system cannot do its job, and it does not kick into gear in action until someone rings the alarm bell, whether that's a community member or whether that's a professional who works with a child. So it's really important that people understand that everyone has a role to play in keeping Pennsylvania's children safe, and that everyone understands what they need to do to make a report.
Yeah, and then we can make a difference.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. And that has something to do with these. Yes. This is the Blue Ribbon. Tell me more about this.
Well, in just a few weeks, it will be Child Abuse Prevention Month. That's the national month designated for us to draw awareness to the issue of child abuse. Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance does a statewide Blue Ribbon campaign, and we're actually launching a campaign statewide that is called Blue Ribbon Champion. And so we'll have an event at the rally for kids on April 5th at the Capitol, and we're encouraging everyone to get involved and to come to the rally. It's a time to really honor the kids who have been abused, and especially those who have lost their lives. But beyond that, we have something really neat this year that we're doing. We hear in the media every day the horror stories of horrific things that happen to children. And so what we know in our line of work is that there are really wonderful things that people do, that average citizens and social workers, child welfare staff members, where people go above and beyond and they really look out for kids and they make a difference. Yeah. So this year, we're honoring four awardees that have been selected by a panel of judges that we've had statewide. And they will get special recognition for specific efforts they took that made the difference in the safety and well-being of a child.
Wow. And that is so important.
Yeah, it is. And you can't stress how important that is, because every single day, I mean, we're seeing hundreds and hundreds of kids that are abused and neglected. And someone has to be the champion for them. Someone has to be their hero.
So what were some of the ways that the champions have stepped in?
Oh, there's been so many wonderful folks nominated. Sometimes it's been a volunteer who knew of a family in need and made sure that the kids had clothing that they needed and got the family to services that actually helped their situation. Other times, there was one nominee where an individual actually saved the life of a child from a violent attack within a daycare center. We've had cases of folks nominated because they actually called Child Protective Services, and in essence, a child was rescued from extreme cases of abuse or neglect. It's really about folks stepping out of sometimes their comfort zone and doing what is best for kids. And we've seen cases of that throughout the state. It's really been very heartwarming.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and if I can add to that, I mean, some of these champions are people who themselves are willing to take children in to be a part of that family's life and be a support system for them and for the children. Yeah. So, you know.
If we're trying to flag this and to pay attention and to be alert, how would we define abuse? What do we look for?
There are lots of signs and symptoms of child abuse, and the law is fairly stringent, though we have relaxed it a bit the last few years in terms of what meets the legal definition of child abuse in Pennsylvania. I think for the purpose of viewers, obviously, if you see visual marks on a child that don't quite make sense with what you've heard has happened to cause the injury, if you see a child who is displaying behaviors that don't seem quite right for the situation, if you see, obviously, a child that is not is being more socially isolated, not attending school, appears to be losing weight, perhaps not dressed appropriately for the season. There's all kinds of indicators. It's really important that folks get some education on this, and that's where we come in. We encourage folks to reach out to Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance. We do great community trainings called the Front Porch Project, and we also do the mandated reporter training.
Yeah, so we're gonna put the website up on the screen. What are we gonna find there?
You're gonna find at pablueribbonchampion.org wonderful opportunities to get involved with the April 5th event. We're hoping that folks will sponsor blue ribbon flags. The state grounds of the Capitol will have 4,203 blue flags on it leading up to April 5th and then a few days past that. That signifies one flag, one large blue ribbon for each child who's been a victim of abuse in Pennsylvania. So we hope that folks will help sponsor that. We hope that folks will come out to the rally. So there's information on that site about the rally. We want folks to really stand in solidarity. You know, in the last several months, we've seen people from all parts of this country come together, unified around issues of concern. What we're saying is, it's time to put Pennsylvania's children as a real priority, an issue that we all get behind, because the reality is, if we each do our part, we can really prevent child abuse.
We really can. A final thought from you, Terry, about this.
Well, again, this is why I've been doing this for 24 years, and it's always, for the folks that are on the inside and actually doing the investigations, it's always great, I think, and wonderful to see people that wrap around children and wrap around families and support them and help them out and be, those champions and the heroes that sometimes folks don't want to do.
So, yeah. Thank you for all that you do, and thank you for giving us a way to help our children, because it really makes a difference to each of us, our community, and just everyone, absolutely. We're going to take a brief pause. When we come back, we're going to talk more about Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance. So stay with us. Welcome back to Behind the Lines. We're talking about Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance. And with us right now, we have Ellen Brown. And Ellen, you are the Director of Development. Thank you so much for being with us today.
It's a pleasure to be here, Diane.
And Lynn Carson, you are Manager of Pinnacle Health Children's Resource Center. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having us.
It does take a village, and it does take a lot of people. It takes a lot of organizations to make a difference and do this good work. Tell me this relationship and how this came about, Ellen.
Well, we were really pleased that Pinnacle Health was one of the first businesses or corporations in the area to hear about what it is that we're doing with our Blue Ribbon Champion event. And we approached them and told them what our ideas were, and they said immediately, absolutely, we'd love to be a part of this. And we're reaching out to businesses all across the state, asking them to join in this effort so that we have the funds available to take our message to communities and individuals throughout the state all year long.
Okay. So what do you really do, Lynn?
Okay, well, I am the manager of what's called a child advocacy center. After a report of sexual or physical abuse comes in to children and youth, they will refer the child to my agency, which is part of Pinnacle Health System. When the child arrives, we will interview the child to find out about their abuse. We also conduct a medical exam to make sure that they're safe and that there's no medical problems. And then we also assess the child for any kind of trauma that they may have experienced or that they may be feeling, emotional trauma, so that we can make sure they get assistance, get the right mental health assistance.
Okay. All right. You also have other sponsors that are involved, too.
We do. PSECU and iHeartMedia are our two major sponsors. They are backing this event, and you'll see their logos everywhere. We have publicity about this because they stepped up as our two main corporate sponsors. So we're grateful for everything that they are doing to help support us in carrying our message to the community.
So once again, this rally is going to be where and what time and how long?
It's going to be held at the State Capitol Building, on the steps of the State Capitol Building, on April the 5th at noon. And we expect the rally to go about 45 minutes. So people can easily come and join us over their lunch hour and help us recognize our Blue Ribbon Champions, and also make a statement that they stand for children of Pennsylvania as well.
Yeah. The work that you're doing is really important.
Yes.
And it's powerful.
Yes, it certainly is. We have been around the Child Advocacy Center for about 22 years. We've seen over 10,000 children. We saw 1,200 last year alone. And I think that the message that I would want to get out is that it's difficult to think about child abuse. People typically turn away. They don't like to talk about it or think about it. But it is here, and I would ask people to be brave and to step up and really be a part of helping to prevent child abuse.
And that's things that we were talking about in the earlier segment. Mm-hmm. And we need to just step up, and it's made easy, right? We don't even have to necessarily identify ourselves.
Right.
Is that correct,
right,
Ellen?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. It is easy. All people have to do is make a telephone call. And if they're uncomfortable, they can make the call anonymously if they're a citizen. A mandated reporter has to supply their name, but citizens can make these calls anonymously. And I think what's important for people to understand is that we would hope that everybody understands that it is their responsibility to be a voice for a child that doesn't have one in a situation like this.
Absolutely. And it makes all the difference in the world for that child and for the rest of us then too. Can you tell me a little bit more about the Front Porch Project?
Well, the Front Porch Project is really a great project that we take to communities throughout the entire Commonwealth. We'll take it to churches, we'll take it to scout troops. We ask people to come together where we actually can recreate everyday situations that you might run into, be it in the line in the grocery store or at a restaurant where somebody's getting loud and a situation needs to be diffused, and teach people how you can step in and diffuse certain situations so that the level goes down and the kids feel as though they aren't going to be a target.
Okay, so this is something that's open to who?
To anybody who would like to participate. All they have to do is call Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance. And
can we find that on the website
as
well?
Yes, it's on the website as well, and information about the Front Porch Project is on there, and if you call our office, we're happy to schedule a training in your neighborhood.
That's great.
With your group of folks.
Right. So we really can reach out to get all of the support. One of the other things you do is parent support programs.
Yes, we do parent support programs. Listen, nobody becomes a parent with a training manual. Mm-hmm. You know, we all know as parents that we face challenges, and there isn't a person out there who knows how to react 100% of the time to a situation. So we do parent support programs to teach children, or excuse me, parents ways that they can react to their children that is not going to be angry, and ways to work through and discuss situations so that there's resolution without the situation blowing up. And I'm sure that Lynn can speak to that as well.
Can you tell me a little bit more about that, Lynn?
Yes. So we see, as I said, we saw 1,200 children, and predominantly the children that we see are victims of sexual abuse. I would say probably 70% of them. But we are seeing increasing numbers of children who have experienced physical abuse. And with the physical abuse, what we're seeing is it most of the time, it's not bad parents. It's just parents that don't know. They're under a lot of stress.
Right.
They're just under a lot of stress, and they don't know how to react, and they often react in the way they were parented. And so things can get out of control quickly, and so that's what we see with the physical abuse. The sexual abuse is definitely, that's different. That we see the offenders are often known to the child. It's either a family member or a relative. And, you know, that's a bit different. But as I said, we see both the physical and sexual abuse, and also some neglect cases.
So it's being aware, and it's breaking cycles, it's breaking patterns when you call people on this and educate them in a way that they can understand.
I don't think anybody wants to be a bad parent.
No.
But people face difficult situations, so we're here to help them understand how to work through these situations.
You also have a network of about 50 affiliates.
We do. We have affiliates like the Children's Resource Center across the state who rely upon us for training, and then they take the message that we offer into their own community. So we're really sort of a one-stop shop for all of the resources that you need, whether it be mandated reporter training or community training, so that we can help build awareness and get people to understand that we all have responsibility for the children in our community.
Yeah. Once again, we're going to put the website up on the screen, and tell us once again, in case people are just joining us, about these blue ribbons.
Well, the blue ribbon is what we use to signify awareness about child abuse prevention. And this is part of an event that's going to be held April 5th at the Capitol, on the Capitol steps at noon, and it's going to be really to honor, to recognize champions who, mm-hmm. who step in, but also to honor the children of Pennsylvania who have been victims of abuse.
And one of the ways we're going to be doing that, Diane, I think it's going to be really breathtaking. We're going to have almost 4,300 blue ribbon stakes in the ground throughout the entire mm-hmm. Capitol. I'd like to say it's going to, unfortunately or fortunately, however you want to look at it, look like a little Normandy, so that mm-hmm. people mm-hmm. have some sense yes. of the real impact, because we all think about this and we all hear about it, but being able to visualize the impact, the toll that this is taking on our kids, and they're our future.
Yes.
You know, so we really do need to step up and protect our children, because they deserve a voice and they deserve the right to a future and a life free from abuse and neglect.
That's right, and I like the phrase that you say, we all can be champions for kids, because we all can protect them. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it starts as simply as making that phone call.
Absolutely.
To help mm-hmm. a child with their life. Mm-hmm. Thank
Absolutely.
You for all the work that you do. And this okay. rally is going to be a really good thing to bring some awareness. We're going to take a brief pause. We'll be back with some final thoughts. Stay with us. We've been talking about the Pennsylvania Family Support Alliance. Angela, give me a final thought.
Final thought is, we want to ask all your viewers to turn out to the steps of the state capitol on April 5th at high noon to really celebrate and thank four extraordinary champions for kids who've been nominated and received awards that say they've done something above and beyond to really help a child and make a difference in their lives. And then two, to acknowledge those 4,203 children who were victims of child abuse, and those 34 who gave their lives as a result of abuse and neglect. It's very important. What we need to remember is that everyone has a role to play in keeping kids safe.
Yes.
Beyond that, we can all be a champion, because the truth is, each and every child needs a champion.
Yes, briefly, Ellen.
Well, along the lines of the nearly 4,300 blue ribbon stakes, folks can text the word champion to 20222. And donate $10 as their way of recognizing these children that
yes.
have been victims of abuse and neglect. And we're happy for the support that the community would be willing to provide to
Thank
us
you.
For this.
Thank you so much, and we will do that. Thank you for joining us today, too, and we can make a difference. I'm Diane Dayton with Behind the Lines, reminding you to look behind the lines. You might be surprised what you find.